It's Dana for the Period Channel 5 o'clock news for this Sunday evening, November 16, 2014. Good evening, everybody. I'm Peter Wiggins, and I got 5 o'clock news headlines on the Sunday evening here. And our top story at 5 o'clock here is Peter Kasich is the fifth Western hostage ISIS apparently beheaded as he converted Islam during his captivity and also went by the name Abdul Rahim Kasich, as Obama calls hostage beheaded ISIS an act of pure evil. U.S. intelligence chief describes mission to free detainees in North Korea. Showing no signs of backing down, President Obama strongly pushed back against critics, questioned his authority to bypass Congress and act an elevator to reform the nation's immigration system. The last draw for Will Muschamp champ was apparently the 23-20 Florida Gators lost to South Carolina and the former Florida coach Steve Spurrier. A cruise ship has been hit with an outbreak of norovirus just 6 months after dealing with another bout at the summit flag early this year. The Botox maker Allergen is hoping to cut off a hostile takeover campaign by Valiant as activists are near deal to buy the Botox maker Allergen for more than $62 billion. People briefed on the matter said on Sunday. Wreckage from the scene of the Malaysian Airlines Flight 17 crash in eastern Ukraine has finally begun to be moved 4 months after the aircraft was apparently shut down with a loss of all aboard. Russian President Vladimir Putin denied he left G20 under pressure. Romanian Prime Minister and candidate of the Real Social Democratic Party, Victor Ponta, right, cast his bet alongside wife Dacina Serba, accompanied by son Andrei and daughter Irina, activated polling station Bucharest as Romania's Prime Minister concedes defeat and runoff. At least 3 people were killed and 22 injured in a bomb blast targeted in the car of lawmaker and vocal Taliban critic Shikria Bukazovsky. PM Benjamin Netanyahu votes to push forward the bill, promising an equal rights to all citizens while recognizing that Israel is a nation state of the Jewish people. The city of St. Louis and Ferguson should offer him a fair severance so he can relocate away from this madness. He is a police officer that was doing his job when he was attacked by a law. A Los Angeles, Bill Cosby will not deny decade-old discredited claims of sexual abuse with a response his attorney said on Sunday. The first comment from the famed comedian of an increasing uproar over allegations that he assaulted several women. A U.S.-Canadian advisory agency wants to find out more about the cost of the health risk posed by the string of the LJ blooms of Lake Erie. Verizon's controversial permacookie that used to track the web activities of its users sparked an outrage among the privacy-concerned users when it was revealed earlier this month. After AT&T and Verizon permacookies landed the company in a privacy firestorm, Facebook is the next to land under generalized scrutiny after the surprising users with its recent private policy. 20 years after Dumb and Dumber raised stupidity to not form a painful sequel, has won the Wakes box office game, netting $38.1 million of ticket sales at the U.S. box office this weekend. Jennifer Lawrence is centered by her co-stars Liam Hemsworth and Josh Hutcherson Wall attended a press conference at Hunger Games as Liam Hemsworth says kissing Jennifer Lawrence was uncomfortable. It's official! Solange Knowles tied the knot with a long-time love. Alan Ferguson on Sunday in front of at least 50 close friends and family. Amanda Barrett went on a rant where she explicitly said she wanted to kill her father, an audio obtained by TMZ. On an impressive moment of space exploration, a robot probe was able to land on a comet for the first time ever. The most accurate laboratory measurement yet made of magnetic fields by trapped in grains with and a primitive meteorite and are provided of important clues to how the early solar system evolved. Recently, the researchers have spotted a gas giant illuminated and inexplicable storms appeared in the atmosphere of Uranus. Health and Human Services Secretary Sylvia Brenner suggested while answered a reporter's question following a tour of the Greater Prince William Community Health Center. Evergreen Terrace in Manassas, Virginia, California has adopted some of the nation's strongest regulations to protect doctors, nurses, and other health workers treating patients with Ebola. Take a look at New England Incident Alerts here. An escaped inmate, the Massachusetts Department of Corrections needs your help to apprehend inmate Gary Smith. Inmate Smith walked away from the Brookcast pre-release facility in Boston. Please do not try to apprehend Gary Smith. He is serving a 3-7 year sentence on War Radio. For questions or additional information, contact the MADOC Office of Investigative Service at 508-473-9509. The 24-hour duty station at 508-422-3481. Or to leave an anonymous tip, call 508-657-4302. Take a look at Fox News here on this Sunday evening here. Wisconsin ran back Melvin Gordon runs record wild 5 takeaways from college as a 48-yard advantage victory against Nebraska on Saturday. In Cleveland, J.J. Watt caught a 2-yard touchdown pass from Ryan Mount, dominating the defense and a Houston Texans comeback to 500 and win a 23-7 win over the Cleveland Browns on Sunday. The Sacramento Kings have agreed to a 3-year contract extension for Rudy Gay. Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Nick Saban and his Alabama players kept saying that being just outside the top 4 of the college football playoff ranking didn't really matter with the big games remaining, and Ace Buffer, New Jersey paid no attention to final score 16-10 loss. That was a game that Giants had no business being in despite the San Francisco 49ers giving them playoff opportunities to take control, at least win. As Eli Manning, 5 interceptions. NBA score, 1 game. New York Knickerbockers over the Denver Nuggets, 103-109-93. And all of the NFL scoreboard coming up at 7 o'clock. Gear, as we're seeing, Green Bay leading Philadelphia 10-0 with 2:40 left in the first quarter. Arizona 14, Detroit 3 with 2:11 left in the first quarter. San Diego Chargers 7, Oakland Raiders 3 with 12:27 left in the second quarter. Atlanta edge out Carolina 19-17. Tampa Bay 27, Washington 7, San Francisco 16, New York Giants 10, Kansas City 24, Seattle 20. St. Louis Rams shocking Denver 22-7. Cincinnati 27, New Orleans 10, Chicago Bears 21, Minnesota Soda 13 and Houston 23, Cleveland 7. Hit a Sunday night showdown in an Indy. Tom Brady and Patriots squaring off. And reluctantly, the Indianapolis Colts 8:30 p.m. Should be a good game. Peter Chalanus on 5:07. Time now for a little traffic report here. And it's both 7 highways and byways, except for some 2 slow spots here. 2 slow spots here. An accident. An accident on 95 on the northbound side between 152 and 495 in North Andover, and another accident on the on-ramp to 95 north from 495. An accident in Mansfield, overturned vehicle, right lane, blocked on 95 northbound before exit 6, route 495, stop and go traffic if I have exit 4, route 295 in Andover. Here, and route 4. Up to the Colonel Berman Highway here. A little slow around East Greenwich. But otherwise, a smooth sailing commute there on this Sunday evening here as we take a look at the weather situation here. The weather scene here. And our current conditions here in North Massachusetts at 5:08. 39 degrees on temperature with overcast skies. Group of the 67%. Wind speed is calm. But Ryman 3 for 23 inches. Dew about 29 degrees and a visibility of 10 miles. All right, let's take a look at what is going on in current conditions around the region here. 41 degrees at temperature right now here in Boston. 41 in Bedford and Beverly. 42 in April. 40 in Gloucester. 40 in Fitchburg. 36 in Worcester. 38 in Sturbridge. 39 in Webster. 41 in Milford and Norwood and Taunton and Plymouth and Provincetown. It's 42 in New Bedford. 41 in Falmouth. 46 in Chatham. 47 in Nantucket. 44 in Martha's Vineyard. And 48 in Cape Cod Bay. 45 in Block Island. 44 in Westley. 43 in Providence. It's 39 in Smithfield. 45 in New York City and Nisselbin and Montauk. 44 in Bridgeport. 43 in New Haven. 44 in Long Island, 40 in Danbury, 37 in Waterbury, 41 out in Meriden, Connecticut, 42 in Hartford and Winslow, Connecticut, 39 in Springfield, 36 in Amherst, it's 38 out in Greenfield, Massachusetts, 37 in Apple, it's 37 in North Adams, Massachusetts, 34 in Pittsfield, Massachusetts, 39 in Albany, New York, it's 30 in Saratoga Springs, 37 in Rutland, 37 in Bennington, 34 in Brattleboro, Vermont, it is 37 in Keene, 36 in Jeff, Hampshire, 37 in Lacourne, Hampshire, and in Manchester, Hampshire, 38 in Concord, Hampshire, 41 in Nashville, Hampshire, 40 in Portland, Hampshire, and 40 up in Portland, Maine. Here, current conditions rain. The nation here shows a cold front from Alberta stretching the dam from Montana up to North Dakota to end up in northern Minnesota. Pink front from Western Ontario with a little part there. And a cold front from California stretching up to Arizona, colliding with a cold front from New Mexico, stretching on Western Texas and cold front from Oklahoma, stretching in Missouri down from Illinois up to Wisconsin and Stacey front. Down from the Northern Great Lakes, down from Ontario, down to Western Quebec, the Seychelles front, down from the Gulf States, down from Georgia here. We got a front by from 7th of Ontario, down from Western Pittsburgh, down from West Virginia, down from Kentucky. Another front by down for the Carolinas, and down for Georgia, and not for Florida. We got a fundamental for western Colorado. They have a northwestern portion of New Mexico. And a fundamental dam for California, of course, on the Gulf of California, Mexico. And a fundamental up in the northern Mexico here. And a fundamental dam for Saskatchewan and southern Manitoba. And a fundamental dam for Quebec here. High pressure in eastern Washington State and eastern Idaho and western Texas here. And high pressure in eastern North Carolina and off the New England coastline here. While we have some low pressure in western Ontario, northeastern UP and Michigan, and southern Mississippi and southeastern portions of Texas. 35 degrees of temperature right now here in Detroit. It's 39 out of Pittsburgh, 48 in Washington, D.C., 49 in Atlanta, Georgia, 82 in Miami, Florida. It's 80 in Brownsville, Texas. It's 38 in Dallas, Texas. It's 22 in Kansas City, 31 in Chicago, 22 in Omaha, Nebraska, 12 in Minneapolis, St. Paul, 27 in Great Falls, Montana. It's 27 in Salt Lake City, Utah, 46 in Seattle, 63 in San Francisco, 71 in Los Angeles. It is 54 in Las Vegas, 71 in Phoenix, Arizona, 39 in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and it's 30 out in Denver, Colorado. Where? That's weird. Warmer than Dallas. 3 degrees warmer than Dallas in Boston here. Okay, take a look at radar situation here. Show some spotty rain showers off the New England coastline and spotty rain showers off the Rhode Island and Long Island coastline here. And we're seeing, gonna zoom you up to the Cape Menounds, and we're seeing some a little rain showers around Wheel Fleet around Cooksburg Beach and around Near East Ham here. So Cape Downs getting a few showers here and a few showers around in Cape Downs here, and we're seeing some rain showers around Dartmouth, around New Bedford, around Westport Horseneck Beach, around off the Newport Rhode Island coastline off the Taconic here. In Southeast Rhode Island. Ooh, and a little rain showers around West Greenwich here. We'll zoom you out. Around the country, we're showing a lot of rain showers from southeastern Pennsylvania down for the Baltimore-Washington corridor, around Maryland, D.C., down for West Virginia, down to East Kentucky, Tennessee, down for northern Georgia, down for Alabama, Mississippi, down for Louisiana, down for southeastern portions of Texas. Well, a lot of snow showers up in a few spotty rain showers around north central Vermont, up in the northern New Hampshire, around Maine, snow and sleet showers in southern and eastern portions of New Brunswick, Atlanta, snow showers west central portions of Prince Edward Island, snow showers in southern Quebec, down for Ontario, and stretching out in the Great Lakes, down for southern Missouri, down for Arizona, down for Oklahoma, down for western Texas, down for eastern portions of New Mexico, spotty snow showers in central Colorado, western Wyoming, Montana, down for the Dakotas, Nebraska, and down for Minnesota, down for southwestern portions of Ontario, and snow showers in central portions of Saskatchewan, now for southeastern and east central portions of Alberta, and now for east central portions of British Columbia. Rain showers off the California coastline here. And rain showers around eastern North Carolina here. Okay. Line of clouds covered much on the Stanley Loop from much of the eastern portion of the country and around the Midwest and down for southeastern states and down for middle and southern Mississippi Valley down for southern plains from Kansas, Oklahoma down for Texas. And then our line of clouds went Minnesota down for Dakotas, Nebraska down for Montana, Wyoming down for northern Colorado, and up in Alberta down for Quebec here, and then our line Canada. And then a lot of spotty clouds went in the Four Quarter region, Nevada, northern and southern portions of California here. And stretch it out to sea. At the Pacific off Alaska. Alright, let's take a look at forecast discussion around the country here. A first surge of Arctic air will bring another dose of winter weather to the central and eastern United States. Heavy snow possible from the Arval to the ports of the northeast. Severe thunderstorms possible across portions of the central and eastern Gulf Coast states. A large upper level trail will amplify across the central and eastern U.S. during a short range forecast period, ushering a number of rounds of Arctic air into these areas beyond the cold front. A wave of low pressure at the surface will develop along the lingering frontal boundary near the Gulf Coast and move northeast weather to the Tennessee Valley tonight and in the northeast by Monday afternoon in a cold area and early in a place across. Most of the central and eastern United States thus expect the potential for widespread winter precipitation of many areas from the Southern Plains to the northeast of the district with a low pressure system as it moves northeast where there's heavy snow as possible in some areas and across several portions of the Gulf Coast states. Warmer boys that are ahead of a low pressure system will result in some potential for showers and thunderstorms, some of which could be severe by Monday. Please refer to correct that looks. And another unseasonably cold air mass. Arctic cold air mass will invade most of the southern United States away from the frontal system with forecast temperatures on Monday and Tuesday 20 to 40 degrees below average for many locations. Meanwhile, high pressure loft into the surface will keep the western United States dry with during the forecast period here. As we take a look at the forecast discussion and region here, and it shows high pressure. We'll move offshore this afternoon, intensifying low pressure over the Gulf Coast states. We'll track northeastward over southern New England on Monday and Monday night and bring a soaking rain to the region and start as light winter mix across the interior. Coast areas may experience damaging winds. Rain to dry and weather falls beyond. The front end Tuesday is unseasonably cold and buster conditions will persist for much of the week. Temperatures have continued to be slow to rebound due to mid and high level cloud cover, so have lowered by a couple of degrees for the remainder of the afternoon. Nantucket and all we reach 49 degrees half in southwest winds, but so still look like mid-40s seems reasonable for Eastern Connecticut, Rhode Island, and Eastern Massachusetts. We have very dry or low levels, so radar echoes over the area will not translate to precipitation reach to the ground. Here. And we got a forecast here. And tonight's lows, we will see temperatures mainly in the 30s of the metro region to around 43 degrees around New York City. So 30s for the metro region of 43 in New York City. You know how cold it was? Check out Buffers been in Massachusetts. This morning's low, 14 degrees. And look at Taunton this morning, 19 degrees. And here we have it. We have a wind advisory in effect from November 17th from 3 p.m. till 10 p.m. So a period of 7 hours here as the National Weather Service in Taunton Institute wind advisory, which is in effect from 3 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Monday. The high wind watch is no longer in effect. Location mentioned, Rhode Island into Southeast Massachusetts. Wind southwest 20 to 30 miles per hour, gusts up to 50 miles an hour. Time in late Monday afternoon, Monday evening there. In fact, winds gusts may be strong enough to knock down some tree limbs and a few power lines, possibly causing isolated power outages here. A wind advisory is issued when sustained winds are forecasted to be 31 to 39 miles per hour, or gusts will range between 46 to 57 miles an hour. Winds this strong can be capable of throwing some small tree limbs and branches that possibly causing isolated power outages, and driving can also be difficult, especially for high-profile vehicles. Day 1 to 8 to 9, as weather not expected to have. Day 2 for 7, Monday for Saturday, a high wind watch. Okay, let's take a look at 7-day forecast goes like this. Tonight, rain likely be after 3 a.m. Punch wild gusts at 4 a.m. Overall, sky's got a low about 36 degrees, light available wind, chest patient 70%. New precipitation amounts between 7 quarter and 8 possible. Monday, rain met punch wild gusts. Monday, rain punch wild higher to 59 degrees, light available wind becoming south of 8 to 13 miles per hour in the afternoon, chest patient 9%. New precipitation amounts between 3 quarters of what is possible. Monday night, rain possibly a thunderstorm before 11 p.m. to the chests of rain. Some source polluters, every rainfall, punch bug before 10 p.m., low around 35 degrees, breeze with a southward about 19 to 24 miles per kilometer, west around 9 to 14 miles per hour after midnight. West Kinko size, 46 miles per chest patient, 9% new precipitation amounts between 3 quarters and 1 inch possible. Tuesday, most of the sky about 40 degrees, west with about 9 to 6 miles per hour. So that part class got low about 21 degrees, west with about 14 miles per kilometer, size 29 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny sky high about 35 degrees, west of that, most of the sky with a low around 26 degrees. Thursday, most of the sky about 44 degrees. Thursday, park class got low about 26 degrees. Friday, most of the sky about 40 degrees. Friday night, park class got low about 24 degrees. Saturday, most of the sky about 39 degrees. Saturday, park class got low about 25 degrees. And for Sunday, most of the sky have about 46 degrees. Peters, what a phrase of the day. Wet Monday in town. That's the Peter James. Have a good evening with good advice attitude. I will see you for a late night report, right after sports roundup, right after the Patriots Colts game. Have a good evening and goodbye to you today. Goodbye!